want to talk smack to me, Zack Ryder? Yeah, Tim.
Ashton Kutcher.
How you doing?
Good. How are you? So good to see you.
Good to see you.
Wow. Is everything okay?
No, this guy, Zack Ryder, is talking smack on Twitter to me. I don't think it's a very good idea. Does he even know I'm hosting the show?
Does he know you have 5 million followers?
Does he know that I'm hosting the show?
Apparently.
And I got the keys to the castle tonight? I don't know. You know what?
So since you're guest host, what do you plan to do to Mr. Woo-woo-woo?
Well, you know, I got this movie Killers coming out. I don't know if you've seen the...
Of course I.
So I play a hitman in this movie, and so I learned a little something about putting a hit on somebody. So I think tonight I'm putting a hit on Zack Ryder.
I think that'll do.
And it could be anybody. It could be a referee. It could be you. It could be another wrestler. It could be an announcer. It could be pretty much, it could be me. Yeah. Can I help you?
Yeah. You wanted to see me, Ashton? And let me guess why. You wanted to see the biggest WWE superstar, me. You wanted me to add some star power to your career by maybe starring alongside you in Killers Part 2.
I didn't know you did stand-up. That's hilarious.
Stand-up, this isn't
stand-up. No, listen. Yeah, well, you're standing and you're making jokes. So, listen. Bret Hart, your GM, I think you know him.
Yeah.
Are you familiar with him? Did he hand you your business at one point? I think I recall that.
So what does Bret Hart want?
So I had a little conversation with Bret Hart, and we felt like we needed to set up a match for you tonight.
Against who?
Well, we got a one-night contract... with somebody you might actually know this person. Daniel Bryan?
Is that supposed to scare me? Is that supposed to be some sort of punishment?
Are you scared?
No, I'm not scared. Do you have any idea what I'm going to do to Daniel Bryan?
What are you going to do to Daniel Bryan?
I'm going to beat him to a bloody pulp. Do you understand what I've been going through with Daniel Bryan?
It's
going
to be very difficult to do when Daniel Bryan makes you tap out.
Ashton, why don't you go get your little Nikon camera and you take a bunch of pictures of what I do to Daniel Bryan.
If I had my Nikon camera here right now, you wouldn't even be able to see it because it'd be shoved so far up your...
Whoa. We're TV PG.
Go get ready for your match.
Maybe I will.
Because you don't want to see the farmhand.
The farmhand? Really?
Can I see the farmhand?
I'll show you the farmhand. What is he, like a buck 05? I could take him, right?
Easily.
Awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the new United States Champion, R-Truth!
Y'all know what time it is! This is the part where we crank it up! Let's crank it up! Here we go! Yeah, what's up? BB stand up, face up! What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up?
Ladies and gentlemen, what a night last Monday night on Raw. New general manager Bret Hart had abdicated and vacated the United States Championship. So it was up for grabs. He put R-Truth in a matchup against the former United States Champion, The Miz.
And you know, I think The Miz thought that there was no way that he wasn't going to regain the U.S. title that he had held and it's become so fond of. But man, R-Truth took The Miz to the limit and finally delivered that lie detector, as R-Truth calls it. And it was all over.
It was R-Truth's first major singles championship here in WWE.
What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? Austin, Texas! What's up?
What's up?
Who would have taken
looks like he's all business here tonight in front of this over 13,000 capacity crowd at the University of Texas. Now, this is not a title matchup, but an important one, however, for Chris Jericho. You have to believe a victory here tonight would put him in the running for a United States Championship match down the road.
And you can tell from that smug look on the face of Jericho that he knows that. And I'm just going to tell you something. The talk in the locker room for people like Jericho, for people like The Miz, they think that they're going to be able to take R-Truth. They think that R-Truth is going to be right before he really gets his feet wet and gets a good hold on that championship. They think he's ripe for the picking.
Well, that is what you're going to have to contend with, the unorthodox style of the new United States champion.
I don't know what Jericho's question was, but that was a pretty good answer from R-Truth.
So it's Jericho versus R-Truth here on Monday Night Raw. Hope you've enjoyed your Memorial Day, everybody. Welcome to Raw, live from the University of Texas. Wild start already with the incident between Evan Bourne and Edge and then Randy Orton as Jericho has floored the United States champion from the get-go. Oh. Nice hip toss by R-Truth.
I think guys like Jericho and The Miz are going to find out that there's a little more substance to R-Truth than they realize.
Look at this. Definitely, as Jericho is sent through the second rope.
What's up? But what's down is Jericho right now. Look out, incoming!
R-Truth! With that high explosive offensive style, right now the new United States champion R-Truth's cruising. Can Jericho get back in it when we return live to Raw?